Hi guys, and welcome to this Divi Theme eCommerce tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. In this series of videos, we're going to be building an eCommerce website using the fantastic Divi theme. When I say eCommerce website, of course, I mean an online store or a web store, whatever you want to call it. Divi Theme by Elegant Themes is absolutely awesome. It is a premium theme, but it's just so easy to work with and has such fantastic features. We're going to use it in this series of videos. So let's get started. I'm presuming you've got a WordPress site up already and you've got WordPress installed. Here's a generic install of WordPress right here. And we've got the 2017 theme installed by default here. So what we want to do, we want to go over and get our Divi theme from Elegant Theme. So if you go over to Elegant Themes here, and I'll put the link below this video, and if you want to download it from my affiliate link, that's great. It won't make any difference to you, but it will help me out. Otherwise, just go over to elegantthemes.com. You'll probably have to start an account, which is free. Just, you know, usual thing, put in your email and password. And once you're in there, you can go down to the download section. And here's our Divi theme. And of course, they've got some other great themes here too. And they've also got some fantastic plugins, but we'll be dealing with those later on. Divi Builder, gonna have to have that. Bloom, I'll be using that, and Monarch as well. These are sort of social media sharing and email opt-in plugins, which are great for getting your site out there and getting email addresses so you can keep people informed. So let's get the Divi theme first. We're back to our members area here, and let's go ahead and hit the download button and it'll start to download. And we also want to get the Divi Builder plugin. Once Divi's downloaded, we want to go and get a plugin. The Divi Builder, the download button with that one. I'll come back and get these other ones later on. Now you want to save your downloads into a folder where you can find them, obviously. And then let's go to the dashboard of our site. Now the first thing I'm going to want to do is install the theme, the Divi theme. So we go to Appearance and Themes, Add New, and we'll hit the Upload Theme button here. And I've got my downloads in this little folder right here. There's the Divi theme, there's the builder. And in a moment, we're going to download and install the WooCommerce. And all we do is I'm going to left click on that and drag it to the choose file area over here. So I'm left clicking on it and I'm dragging it and just dropping it right beside that button. I'm going to go ahead and install now. Theme installed successfully. Let's go ahead and install our Divi Builder plugin. We'll go to the plugin section. You may find when you install your WordPress at first, it puts a few plugins here, like Jetpack or Hello Dolly, something like that. I would recommend you just click on them and uninstall them or delete them, because they're just taking up space for you, unless you particularly want to use them. I personally don't. Now let's add our Divi Builder plugin here. And again, we're going to go to Upload Plugin. And same thing, I'm going to left click on my Divi Builder zip file and just drop it beside that button. And once it's installed, I'm going to go ahead and activate the plugin. All right, now because our Divi is a premium theme, we will have to activate it. There is our Divi, and it says the new versions are available already. I've just downloaded it from the site, but I'm going to go ahead and update it anyway. That's updated. Now I want to activate it to make it the theme that we're using. Okay, now it's active. I'm going to go ahead and delete this one. So I've just clicked on the image, and down in the bottom right hand side, you'll see a little delete button there. You don't have to delete it, but it just means there's less files on your server. It's taking up less space, and less is better always. Less time to load, less time for the server to crawl through your site and find stuff. Okay, I've got to activate my theme now because, like I said, it is a premium theme, so you do have to pay for it. I just go to Divi, Theme Options, and put in my username and my API key. I'll just go ahead and do that. Now they're in there, I just need to save the changes. Little green check mark means we're all good to go. So we've got our theme installed. Now the next thing we want to do, because we're using an online store, we want to use the WooCommerce plugin. There are other plugins available out there. But if you go to WordPress.org plugins WooCommerce, you'll find it here. And this is a free download. And I'll put this link below the video also. Just hit the download button, same as before. It'll download it to your browser here. Once downloaded, it's exactly the same thing as we use for the Divi builder. So if we go to our dashboard and plugin, here's my little folder. There's my WooCommerce plugin. Again, I'm just going to left click and drag it. When I've hit the add new button, upload plugin, left click and drag, drop it by that little button there, and hit the install now button. It's installed, that's great. Let's go ahead and hit the activate button. Now we'll quickly run through the setup. Okay, so we're in the United States. Actually in Tennessee, not Alabama. I'm not going to put my address in here. You may want to put this address in for you for shipping purposes later on. US dollars, that's fine. I plan to sell both physical and digital products. Well, digital products are things like ebooks or music and stuff like that. So I'll leave that as it is. I'm not going to check that because I'm not going to be selling services. I'm going to uncheck that because I don't particularly want WooCommerce to be tracking me while I'm doing this. So I'm going to hit let's go. Oh, 1, 2, 3. Rainy Street. Hank Hill's address for anybody that didn't know that. Of King of the Hill fame. Let's put in New York. I don't know a zip code for you lot. 5678. There we go. So I've just put in some random details there. You do want to put in your physical address here though, because if you're shipping, it will calculate shipping for you. So let's hit the let go button. Payment options, I always select PayPal. Hit Stripe if you want to, if you have a Stripe account. PayPal allows people to use by credit cards, and it really is a great option. So I'm going to hit that one. I'm going to uncheck the Stripe and we'll continue. You can set WooCommerce up later, but may as well just get it done now. And here's the shipping calculations I was talking about You can put in a weight and the address of where you're shipping it to. It'll automatically calculate it, or you can do a flat rate if you prefer. And we're going to use ounces and inches. If you're in Europe, you probably want to use kilograms and centimeters. Taxes, that's up to you. If you're in the UK, you're going to want to use that. Over here, it's state tax, so it's really up to you. You're going to have to pay tax one way or the other. But I'm just going to go and hit the continue button. I'm building this site offline, so it probably won't let me connect with the Jetpack. I'll hit the skip this step button below, and we're all ready. If you want product updates, put your email address in there. If you want to go ahead and create your first product, obviously hit that one. Or if you want to import products from another site, you can do it with a CSV file. I might actually do that in a while because I've got another site, but we'll do that later on because I'll show you how to set up a product and what have you. So we're good to go. So I'm going to return to the dashboard. So back at the dashboard, you can see we've got WooCommerce here. This is where we're going to be adding products a bit later on. Here's our Divi theme we've got installed. And if we go to the plugins, we've now got the Divi Builder, we've got that Jetpack, WooCommerce, and WooCommerce PayPal. It's done this all for us. So we're ready to get started. So I'll leave it here with this video. In the next video, we'll start customizing our site, putting in our logo and a slider. After that, we'll start adding some products. So I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, please like and share the video. And do subscribe to our channel. If you're interested in web development, we've got some great web development courses down below. There's some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. There's also some great free courses down there. So once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.